this idyllic stock footage from Tesla, juxtaposed with the reality of driving around on a brutally cold morning in downtown St. Louis, provides us a fitting parallel to begin this tale of electric vehicle ownership angst.
It is a lot of fun to drive.
But for Dan Brown and other Illinois electric vehicle owners, that fun behind the wheel is about to cost more. In early June, lawmakers in the cash-strapped state of Illinois approved new legislation that raised the gas tax. Since electric vehicles don't use gas, the new law requires EV owners to pay higher registration fees.
I knew that that was going to start happening on January 1st of 2020, and luckily I was kind of thankful that my car expired in December, so I would hopefully get under the old law.
Or so he thought. The law says electric vehicle owners have until January 1st, 2020 to get a two-year registration for the current $35 fee. But read further and find that beginning January 1st, 2020, EV owners will have to pay the new yearly registration fees totaling $251.
When I put my registration and my PIN code in, I was kind of shocked to find out that it was under the new pricing.
Even though Dan's plates technically expire the final day of 2019, and even though he wants to renew in 2019, he still must pay the higher rate because he's registering his car for 2020. And Dan isn't alone. The Secretary of State's office tells me registration expires on December 31st, 2019 for all of the approximately 18,000 electric vehicles in Illinois.
I have no problem with the new tax. I actually think that electric vehicle owners should pay their fair share to support roads and infrastructure.
Dan says his issue is the language of the new law and the feeling that there's a bit of a moving target so the state doesn't miss out on collecting this first round of new fees from electric vehicle owners. We've posted more information on this issue on the Fox 2 and News 11 apps. There you can also see the questions we asked the Secretary of State's office and the answers we received. For Fox 2 and News 11, I'm Mike Colombo reporting.